Since the Chinese communists led by Chairman Mao occupied Tibet in the 1950s, the Tibetans, you, have faced incredible hardships. Inside Tibet, it is estimated that roughly 1 million Tibetans died as a result of the initial invasion and subsequent destructive policies, including the Cultural Revolution. Tibet's cultural and religious heritage was also devastated at the time. Even after the Maoist period ended, the Tibetan people have continued to suffer intense persecution. The ongoing human rights violations in Tibet are a stain on the whole world. The Communist Party continues to systematically erode Tibetan identity, including through the repression of the Tibetan language and the Tibetan Buddhist religion, and through the imprisonment of leading Tibetan figures, most notably, of course, the Panchen Lama, who has been imprisoned since 1995. As for the Tibetan people who followed His Holiness the Dalai Lama into exile in India in 1959, they have had to struggle to persevere their culture and identity, even while facing all the challenges of being long-term refugees. I speak to you today as an MP and a member of the All Party Group for Tibet. I want to tell you that we see your ongoing struggles. We have not forgotten the truth of Tibet's history as an independent nation, and we will not forget. We will continue to speak out in support of the human rights of the Tibetan people and for a just solution to the Tibetan political question, guided most notably by the middle way approach advocated by His Holiness the Dalai Lama. To finish, I would just like to express my profound respect and admiration for how the Tibetan people, both inside and outside Tibet, have persevered through all the hardship I have spoken about. Despite the efforts of those who seek to destroy them, Tibetan culture and religion continues to survive and even to thrive, not inside the traditional areas of Tibet, but around the world, as we have seen tonight. Tibetan identity remains strong. And moreover, the Tibetan people led by His Holiness the Dalai Lama have earned the respect of the whole world by preserving their identity, not through anger and violence, but through non-violence and compassion. Thank you once again for welcoming me here this evening. Losar Celebration.